Good morning, students. I welcome you all to your English class. So let's begin today's English class. So what is the date today? Yes, today is Friday. And what is the date today? Today is 16th of July 2021. So as you know, it is Friday. So we will be doing English grammar. So all of you take out your new learner's English grammar and composition book. So let's check out today's topic. So today's topic is chapter number 6, Simple Present and Simple Past. So we are going to start with a new chapter today. So all of you open page number 42 and get ready. Now, so today we will learn about simple present tense. So let's quickly see what is the meaning of simple present tense. See here, simple present tense. So what is simple present tense? We use simple present tense in order to describe or talk about daily activities, daily routines, habits and different facts. So for describing different daily activities, then routines, habits and facts, we generally use simple present tense. Now, when to use the simple present tense? Now let's find out how and when are we going to use the simple present tense. Simple present tense is usually used to describe an action that is happening now. So whatever you are doing right at this moment, like I am making this video. So what I am doing? I am making the video. So I am talking about the action which is going on just now. Right? So for that I am using simple present tense. So if you are doing your homework, if you are sitting, if you are playing now, so whatever action you are doing now, for expressing that action or for describing that action, we use simple present tense. Next, we use simple present tense to express any habit or repeated action or a general truth. So, if we talk about any habit, so I eat my breakfast in the morning. So, that is a habit or that is an activity which you do every day. So, repeatedly it keeps on continuing. The sun rises in the east. So that is a general truth or the universal truth. So for that we always use simple present tense. Now here are some examples. See, subject. So what we have to do? First you have the subject. Subject is the person or the thing who is doing that work. Suppose if you are talking about yourself, you will say I. If you are talking about some other person, if he is a boy, you will say he. If the person is a girl, you will say she. If it is a thing, you will say it. So that is the subject. Plus you are going to put the verb and you are going to put s. Yes. Suppose I just now said that I am making a video. What am I doing? I am now making a video. So I is the subject. Making is the verb. So here it is continuous, no? The work is going on. So I am saying making. Okay. So you don't have to add a S. But generally you add S. So here you have got some examples. See, he eats dinner. So we are expressing an action that is taking place in this moment. So what he is doing now? He is eating his dinner or he eats dinner. Number two, they drink water every day. So that is a general or that is a habit that you do every day. So describes an action which happens habitually. It occurs every day. I work hard. So that is a general tool that you do every day. Okay. So you work hard in order to score good marks. So this is how we or when we use simple present tense. So here you can see yet some other instances when we talk about the simple present tense. So when do we use the simple present tense? Now here you can see habits, like as now only we talked, I always drink coffee at work. He goes to bed at 11 p.m. They often eat lunch at school. So these are the habit which we do in our day-to-day life. Future plans or schedules. So when you talk about any future plans or you talk about any schedule or what is your routine, you use simple present tense. Like the train arrives at, so arrive is the verb, so you are adding the S, arrives at 3 p.m. We fly to Paris on Monday. Classes begin next week. So you are talking about something which you are going to do in your future. Then when we talk about any general facts or general truths, we use simple present tense. As I said, the sun rises in the east. So it is a truth, general truth. It is not going to change. So rises. So rise is your verb and you are adding an S. The sun rises in the east. The earth is not flat. Next, water boils at 100 degree centigrade. So all these are general facts and truths. Next, when we talk about present facts and truths, we use simple present tense. Like I live in Washington DC, or you might say I live in Siliguri. She is 80 years old. He works at Microsoft. So all these are facts about which you are talking. So for that also we will use simple present tense. Okay. Now here you come to your book. You can open your book and you can come to page number 42. So in page number 42 you will see verbs that are used to express actions. Actions means to tell you about what is happening, that is taking place in the present time, are said to be in simple present form. So again I am reading, verbs that are used to express actions or talk about a time that is taking place in the present time are said to be simple present forms. They are also used to make general statements. Now see, the simple present has been used in the following ways. Number one, to state all time truth. Just now we had read about it. Examples are water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Next one, the sun and the moon creates tides in our ocean. Next instance is you come to page number 43. You will see number two, to talk about habits or routine. So when you talk about any habits or routine, for example, I go for a walk every morning. I learn to play the violin on Sundays. So these are the routine or your everyday habits. Now number three, to talk about something that is true for the present time which may change later. So examples, like you have, I like ice cream. Next, my sister plays for the school basketball team. So these things are when you are talking about now. Okay, but it might change in the future. Okay, so I hope so you have understood the rules and how and when you are going to use the simple present tense. Okay, now we will move to the exercise. So on page number 43 you will see there's an exercise which you have to do. So let's find out what we have to do. Let's practice. Number one, read the sentences given below. Identify what the present simple form has been used for. Write T for all time truth, H for habit, or TP for true for present on the basis of their use. So on the basis of the uses, we are going to identify them and we are going to write T for if the statement is indicating that it is all time truth. We are going to write H if it is telling us about a habit, and we will write TP if it is saying us about or it is true for the present. Okay, So let's find out. Number A, my pet mongoose runs very fast. So that is TP, that is true for the present. It can change in the future. So you will write TP, capital T and capital P. Number B, the rains comes after the summer. So it is a general truth. So you are going to write T, as it is all time truth. Okay. Next, number C, Jonshia makes very nice momos. So it is true for present. Okay. So you will write T and P, TP. Number D, I go for a dental checkup every 6 months. So it is a habit. Okay. So you are going to write H, capital H. Number E, I say hello to my teacher when I meet her. So that is also your habit. So you are going to write H. Number F, my cousins live next to our house. So that is true for present. Now they are living, might be, they might go to some other place in the future. So you will write T and P. Number G, the gardener cuts the grass every Sunday. So it is his fixed routine which he follows every Sunday. So again you will write H. Okay. Number H, my uncle owns this store. So that is true for present. So you will write TP. Number I agree with you. So again you are going to write T and P. Number J, 365 days make a year. So 365 days make a year, that is truth, all time truth. So you are going to write T for that. Okay. Now you are going to turn the you are going to come down. Fine. So first exercise we have completed. Now we will move to number 2. So what we have to do in number 2, let's find out, fill in the blanks with the correct simple present tense of the verb in the box given below. So the options are given to you, so you have to use the correct option and in its simple present form. Okay. Number A, I dash to my dance class every evening. So it will be I go to my dance class every evening. Number B, Sheila dash the piano very well. So it will be Sheila plays the piano very well. Okay. Number C, the clown dash balls for a living. So you are adding wherever it is necessary, we are going to add S with the verb. So your answer is the clown juggles. So you will add S, juggles balls for a living. Number D, bananas dash on tree. So bananas grow on tree. Okay. So you will write banana grow on trees. Number E, you see, dogs dash to chew on bones. So dogs like to chew on bones. So you are going to turn your page and you will come to page number 44 for the last two numbers. Okay. For the last two sentences. Number F, salty water dash fast. So salty water boils, B-O-I-L-S, boils fast. Number G, astronauts dash to outer space. So astronauts fly to outer space. Okay. So I hope so it's done and you have understood. Yes. So I hope so you are clear with the concept of simple present tense and how and when we are going to use the simple present tense. Okay. So that much for today's English class. All of you take care and be safe. Thank you.